Morning, today I'm talking about the TBMS, established balance to thought wave of computer applications, Power Tables, Database Management, simply called as TBMS. Okay, paper number 61. Today I'm talking about the TBMS approaches. So, DBMS approach is easy to tell us about the database name system to better way. Okay? So, this is used to use the database for a better understanding of the data to give database design is a correctly and efficiently manner. Okay? So, DBMS consists of what it does, what it do. The DBMS can perform operations like insertion, deletion, updation on the database system. We have to use some approaches like this. So approaches are used to in order to remove all the limitation of the file based system. A new approach was required that must be effective. So the concept of the DBMS is introduced to the approach known as the database approach. DBMS, it is centralized, it is controlled, it is controlled the repository. DBMS controls repository. Repository means storing the data, stored data is called as a repository. The DBMS can controlling the repositories. Okay, of shared data allows the several users to access both database concurrently. So by using the DBMS, we can control the repositories, store the data. Repository means in the sense means we can store the data. Next, by this, so we can access the data concurrently. Can access the data concurrently for multiple servers. Okay, we are accessing the multiple servers at the same DBMS. Okay, next, a fundamental feature of the database approach was is database system does not complete the definition and description of the data. Okay, data should be protected from the unauthorized users. Data should be protected from the unauthorized users. Next, by using the username and password, here the DBMS is the main role is the protect the data. From an unauthorized user. Unauthorized persons with the help of the password. And now we are placing the password of the database. The data will be secured and secure effective manner. Okay. So next, the DBMS is the main advantage of the DBMS is the to reduce the redundancy. We can control the redundancy. So redundancy means repetition of the work. Repetition of data is called as redundancy. The DBMS is the main approach is also used to provide the redundancy concept, to control the redundancy concept. Okay? The DBMS is always controlling the redundancy concept. Okay, so these are the DBMS approaches. That means DBMS can be used to manage the large volume of data for a better percent of the data. By using DBMS, we can construct a project. In the DBMS, we can perform some operations like insertion, deletion, updation on the database. That is called the database management system. Here, the DBMS approach is the main approach. It is used to repository of the data. Repository of the data means we can store the data, and here the database can accept the multiple users to access the database both concurrently. Okay, here are the many users used by the DBMS concurrently. Concurrently means simultaneously. Okay, next day, the main advantage of the DBMS is to protect the data from the unauthorized users. Unauthorized users. Whenever you are providing security, you have to put a password. You have to put the password with the help of the DBMS. Without password, we are not able to provide security. So, hence we are using DBMS concept. We are providing the password, and so the data will be secured. Next, coming to the next concept, the DBMS is always used to controlling the redundancy topic. That is, for redundancy means what? Reputation of the word, reputation of the data, or duplication of the data is called the redundancy of the word. Okay, so this is the approaches of the DBMS. The next topic is advantage of the DBMS. Next topic is this is a very short answer. This is very short answer. DBMS advantages. Next topic is advantage of DBMS. This is already I have discussed in the previous classes. Okay, so again I am going to discuss about the advantage of the DBMS. Okay, so what is advantage of DBMS? So the first one is the advantage of DBMS is to reduce the redundancy. Okay, so reduce or control the redundancy. Redundancy means duplication of the data, or the reputation of the data is called as the redundancy. Whenever the redundancy is increased, the data will be automatically increased. So then we are maintaining the data is very high. Whenever the data is increased automatically, our time complexity is also increased, and our strength is also increased, our efficiency is also increased. Hence the result is very poor. Okay, whenever the data will be reduced by the redundancy DBMS topic, then the data will be decreased. Whenever the data will be decreased, automatically program length will be decreased, automatically memory will be decreased. Then the memory improvement is, the memory management is improved, and by using the redundancy topic we can access the data very freely. That is a no such kind of the duplication of the word, duplication of the data. By using the redundancy topic we can perform the memory management very improvedly. Okay, next we can construct the project by using the redundancy topic very easily and effectively and efficiently manner by using the redundancy. Redundancy is used to controlling the data. So hence that is called the one of the best advantage of the DBMS. Okay, redundancy means what here? Redundancy is the duplication of the word. Redundancy means duplication of the word or repetition of the word. Okay, next we come to the DBMS. So this is the best advantage of the DBMS to eliminating the repetition of the word. Is called as a redundancy. Okay, next coming to the second part, that is called consistency data. Here the next advantage is the consistency of the data. Next up here we are using the data is accessing the consistency data. Why? Because the DBMS advantages can have only independent of the data. Hence the data will be always consistency. Consistency means there is no errors, there is no duplication of the data. Hence we are using the data as we need. Why? Because the DBMS can have the The DBMS can have the independent of the data. The DBMS can have data, independent data. Hence, we are using this data as you will like. As you will like the data and manage the DBMS data. Okay, so this is called the consistency. Consistency means stability, stability, not varying. Okay, by using stable data, we can access the any information from the DBMS. Okay. Coming to PowerPoint, that is called experimental data. Experimental data, here the data will be used by the user as he want, as his want, and as his convenience. Okay? Why? Because here the data is always flexible, flexible to the user. He can manage the data as he want. Okay? So why? Because if the data is redundancy, that means random, okay, or there is a data is not fixed any value to the any user, okay, the user is given by the data and taking the data very easily and effectively. Here is also the data will be the independent format. Here the data will be also independent format. Hence he is using the data as he want. Okay. Next to the data. He liked it. He used it to data. He is managed the data as his convenience. Like as his user convenience to organize the large volume data for easily and effectively manner. Okay. So here the data is also independent format. Hence we are using the data very easily, very easily. And the one user can affect the at one level. Affects the one level, it should not affect the another level. Okay, if your user can access the one of the data in the same data, it not affects the other user persons who is working on the same of the data. Why? Because the data will be here. It has a independent format. This data is a flexibility of data. So this is the best example for the DBMS advantages. Okay, so flexibility data. Flexibility data can be accessed by any person as he like. Okay, but consistency, constant data is accessed only certain areas only. Okay, next coming to our fourth part is called integrity of data. Okay, the word integrity means here. What integrity means what here? Integrity means consistency, accuracy. Okay, so the integrity means what here? Integrity means what? Integrity is the consistency of the data or accuracy. Accuracy means perfect data. Okay, there is no errors, there is no duplication of the data, that is called the accuracy of the data. There is a consistency. Consistency means what? Consistency means stable. We are already discussing the second point, consistency data. Okay? The data is also here, is also the data will be kept in the independent format as we are using the data as he wants. Okay? The data is always here. Integrity means the data is always consistency of the data and the accuracy of the data. There is no errors in the data. There is no duplication of the data. The user convenience by using the user convenience, use the this data by using the as by use it to as he likes, really across X. Okay, coming to the word better and faster of the data. Here it can perform a better performance. Here the DBMS can perform better performance. Why? Because of these four conditions. Because there is the data, the DBMS cannot contain any duplication of the data. The DBMS contains consistency of the data. The DBMS contains flexibility of the data. The DBMS contains accuracy of the data. And so the data is to manage the data is very better way. Okay? Because of the above four conditions, we can perform the we can perform the memory management is very improved. Why? Because of the above four conditions, based on the four conditions, the DBMS will be improved and it works as a effective and efficient manner by using the DBMS to perform the operations better across the data. There is no poor across the data. But here, whether the data contains, whether the DBMS contains the tendency topics, going to poor enforcement of the data. But here we are going to reduce the redundancy. Reduce the redundancy means what? To control the redundancy, to filter the duplication of the data. Okay, duplication data, automatically we have to delete the data. Then we are getting only redundancy. Reduce the redundancy. Since we are taking the needed data only, then we can perform the better enforcement of the data. Okay, next is coming to 6 point. High productivity. High productivity data. High performance means, that means high productivity data means what? We can provide, we can produce high performance of the data by using the DBMS. Okay? Why? Because here we can perform the a better way. Here the data, the DBMS can contain the only needed data and flexibility of the data or integrity data or consistency of the data or accuracy data. Hence our performance is also high production. We are providing high productivity of data. We can produce the high productivity of data. Why? Because of these four conditions, automatically the data will be producing very highly. Whenever the data is increased, we can perform operations very easily and efficiently. Okay? Because of the data is also going to very independent. The data will be here is also independent and product produce the given data. Okay? Next. Support Hadoop. Okay, so here the data will be the DBMS can support Hadoop queries. Okay, what is Hadoop queries? What is queries? I will tell you in the fourth unit about the discount SQL structure. That means Hadoop queries means strongest. Okay. So this is also supported by the DBMS with the help of the advantages. Okay, if you are going to discuss about the disadvantages of the DBMS, it not support the Hadoop queries. But coming to the advantages of DBMS, it can support the Hadoop queries. Hadoop queries can support the very easily and efficiently. By the reasons of the above reasons, based on the above reasons, we can support the Hadoop queries. Okay. Provide security. Okay, so here we can provide security. We can provide security with the help of the topic code, username and password. Okay, whenever the data will contain the username and password, that data will be protected by the DBMS. Okay, here we can perform this better enforcement of the data, the better. Going to set the data, reduce the data, integrity the data, hence the weekend performance. Hence, we are also providing the security with the help of the username and password. Okay, coming to fourth unit, we have SQL. In this SQL, we can perform the operations like table creation, table alter, table renewed, and table deleted, table dropped. We can perform number of operations and the things with it. We can perform programming also there. Okay, in fifth year we can also perform some operations in the SQL program. In the SQL program, that is for the Oracle software. Okay, whenever we are going to open the Oracle software, we are going to enter username and password. Without username, without password, we are not able to do SQL programs or SQL commands. Okay, why? Because of the DBMS can provide security. Hence, we are placing the username and password. Okay, in the SQL structure, the default username is also known as the
and the password is tiger. The password is tiger. Okay, this is the universal of the universal username and universal password of the SQL. SQL software, that is called Oracle software. Okay, so these data belongs to the advantages of the DBMS. These data belongs to the advantages of the DBMS. So I hope you understood this class. Thanks for watching this class. And have you any questions? Please ask me after this class. Okay, thank you.